Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Good morning, children. So, I'm your science teacher here. So, now you're in second standard, right? So, just take out your science reader. Page number 142. Our first chapter is living and non-living things. The first one is, what is living thing and non-living thing, right? So, the things that have life is called living thing. And the thing that does not have any life is called non-living thing, right? So you can see in this picture, which can move on its own, right? So there's a dog here and there's a tree here. Which can move on its own? Can you tell me, children? So here, the dog can move on its own, right? In the second picture, which can grow? Chair doesn't grow, right? So it comes under non-living thing. A baby can grow. Then come to the third picture, which one needs air to breathe? A car does not require any air to breathe, right? But a human being requires air to breathe. So, what is environment? Environment means what? It's nothing but the thing that all the thing that all around us, like animal, trees, plant, human being, water, and mostly everything, air, breathe, what we eat, everything comes around us. So it is all parts of our environment. Okay, children? After this, next go to the second page. So see here, this is a small picture you can see. So the picture below shows some of the things you see in environment. Circle the living things in the picture. Now you tell me what would could be circled in this. What are the living thing in this, right? Can you tell me what are the living things in this? So the human beings are the living thing. We circle them. This the squirrels, the rabbits, the butterflies, the flowers, the birds, all this. These all are the living things, right? So next come here, living and non-living thing. What are living thing and what are non-living things, right? Our environment includes both living and non-living thing, right? So things that have life called living thing, like animal, bird, plant, trees, people, what we saw all around us, like hen, cat, baby, trees, dogs, animals, insects, birds, reptiles, species, whatever species we call as living thing, which can live, which have life, is called living thing, okay? So next, go to the next page, 144. Here also you just see here once, things that does not have life called non-living thing, that is soil, rock, air, water and many other things in our environment are called non-living thing. So you can see in this picture, what are the non-living thing parts? The rocks, the water, the air and all these things are non-living things, right? So come here once again. What living things can do? Can you tell me what thing they do? They can breathe, they can move, they can eat, they can play, they can run, they can do everything, right? On its own. But non-living thing does not do anything. Here, they eat, they grow. This is all this come under living thing. They reproduce, more seeds grow into the plants. Animal give birth to young ones. For example, a cow give birth to a calf. A hen lays eggs. See here, the lays egg. This is called the living thing reproduce. But in this following panel, you see here once, they have feelings. The living thing have feeling than non-living thing. For example, we can feel heat or cold heat with one touch. If we touch a hot spot, we can feel it, that is a hot. If we drink a water, cold water, we feel it, that is the water is very cold, right? But the non-living thing does not feel any. So we feel pain when we get hurt. Similarly, the animals and the plant also feel changes around them. If you touch some leaves, they will close, like touch me not plant. Living things ages and die. So all the living thing had come to a particular age and they die, right? But in non-living things, it does not occur.